Hello, I'm Saddam. Again, I'm a lecturer in metallurgy. I'm a scientist. And today I wanted to attend the webinar of Common Sense Society organization. And I defined what is common sense. It is common among the people who are sensible. They have common sense. And it is possessed by illiterate people who are not capable of reading or writing. So they always use their heart to ponder over the things. So common sense is of the heart and not of the head. Of the head, people say, oh, which professor has written this thing? In which article or in which book this thing is written before they accept it? Whereas a man who is illiterate, if you tell him something, he will accept it and he will ponder over his heart where the Holy Spirit is, and he will learn from God the gospel truth. So far he can say yes or no, definitely, not waver on it. As the educated people or the university professors say, maybe, there's no maybe in here, either yes or no, as Christ Jesus has stressed. So they throw me out, and within 5 minutes I was out. So never mind. Common sense is not so common, because most of the people are educated. They have been to university and other things, and whenever you tell them something, they always want to look. Which professor said so? In which book it is written? Somebody has said, then they will accept it, if somebody has said. Otherwise they will say, no, we don't know. Because they have no common sense. Common sense is possessed by illiterate people, and that's why the good news of the birth of Jesus was broken to the shepherd in the field. And they rejoiced, and they came to honor Christ Jesus. And same at Cana, where Jesus prepared the new wine. And those wedding guests, they were not university professors or anything of that type. They were illiterate village people. And they exercised common sense. And when the water, clean water, meaning clean-hearted people, as the village people are, was turned into one new wine, then when it was presented to the illiterate farmers, they appreciated it. And so, Holy Spirit is nothing else but the common sense, and we call it Surti. Surti, same thing in Punjabi or Hindi. So anybody who has common sense, he will understand the gospel. No common sense, no gospel, but dead letters of the books, as the university professors are. Oxford University is not far away from Reading, where I live. So I go there to attend their seminars, and I found them. They don't know that there are two gods, Yahweh, Brahma Khuda, which is the creator of nature, Srishti, and one of our supernatural soul, our supernatural father, Elohim Allah Pabram. That is represented by the middle candle of the menorah. So here it is, the menorah, and you can see the middle candle. So, so this middle panel of the menorah is of God, our supernatural father of our souls. And this is of Yahweh, three here, three here. They are the secular people. And this is a celestial people, Sadhu. So, these are the, by Yahweh, Yahweh is a potter. He has made these pots. Some are human beings, some are elephants, some is dog. All these are soul in them. It is the same as you and me have, which is in everyone. So that's why in God, if somebody hit you, you don't hit him back, because you hit his soul. And God punishes him, because God is the judge over here. And not we are, we just leave it, everything to God. So that's why under worship of God, if somebody hits your one cheek, you present the other cheek. You hit at the conscience of the person. So this is the menorah, six candle of earth, three holy, three evil, social, ecumenical and political affairs. So